What's up, everybody? Welcome. It's day 167 or so, making Songbringer. And since yesterday, I've gotten these mountain tiles. I haven't done that much visually to them. They're about how they were. I'm working mostly on the code behind them to make him a little bit more just solid as far as like some things like this look right here where it's got this cave. This is wrong a little bit, so I need to make that so it's got its own border around it so that the rocks kind of come up at that point. So I'll make that happen. And there's a few Z ordering issues I'm going to be working on today. So I'm partially refining the mountains and things like that, but really the whole goal for today is to get this to be a playable alpha. So this new look with the mountains and these rocks and stuff has really added a nice, beautiful element to the game. But I need to make sure things like when I place a bomb, for example, there might be a bomb right here, or placed a bomb right here, a secret. I just want to make sure that, yeah, for example, see that? There's a place to bomb right there. So I need to work on that. So that's good. At least I have these diamonds now in them. So yeah, that was really weird. For some reason, it just put me back at this point in the world. And then, yeah, I can't go back down. So a lot of work to do to kind of get this refined and to the point where I can release a playable alpha either, is it Tuesday? Yeah, either tomorrow, Wednesday, or probably more like Thursday, I'll be putting out this alpha version to the people that backed at the alpha level and above. Thank you again, backers. Thank you again, everyone who backed the project. This would not be possible without you. I appreciate you. So, okay, yeah, let's start with these Z ordering things. One, I think that these cliff tiles can actually be. I'm gonna actually rename all these mountains too. Just to keep them distinct from the, I was gonna create some mountain or some cliff, actually cliff tiles. So all right. So to keep them distinct versus the mountain tiles, I'm gonna call them cliff. Instead of cliffs, I'm gonna call them mountains. We got K style cliff. Which is all but unused. Wow, need to make that highlight color brighter. Hello, Speedy Flip, 5 viewer hype, right on. What's up, man? I hope you can hear me clearly today. I got a fan on because it's hella hot. So, all right. Max cliff height. Yeah, this would be max mountain height. We keep this ambience cliffs. That's kind of a cliffy sound. Okay, cool. All right, nice. Good to know. Well, yeah, so today all I'm doing is getting the game ready for the alpha version. So it's going to be playable once again. I've kind of made it a habit so far in this project to kind of keep the game in a playable state, in a polished sort of playable state. So by doing these progressive releases, it's helping. It's really helping to keep the game, I don't know, in fighting shape, I guess you could say. Yeah, in shape. All right, there. That's just one simple rename thing, just to keep things clear. When I come back one day and look at this code, I don't want to get confused with cliff tiles versus mountain tiles. So that was kind of important. Next thing I want to do is the Z ordering. So Z ordering the mountain tiles, I think, can actually be done with negative Z. And right now I'm using a positive Z, which puts things at the right places or whatever, but all right, so if all of these are actually negative 990 instead of 1, let's see if that comes out right. Well, that's the hex style. We want to do this the rec style. There. All right, so they're messed up because they're putting the wrong tiles last, I guess. So it needs to be, I think it needs to be the opposite Y. So replace the topped ones first. Yeah, that works. And then the second one goes on top of it. Yeah, yeah. Okay, so these need to be opposite Y. Oh, which is not going to work. Okay. Unless we made all the mountain tiles work in reverse. Right. I guess it's worth trying that. I can try doing it totally in reverse. So when it creates every single tile, this is going to affect everything, but let's see if it works. So we start at a Y of height minus 1. And we go Y is greater than or equal to negative 5. This is Y minus minus. That ought to put those right, but let's hope it doesn't break anything else. Oh yeah, okay. Well, these are right. Oh, it's a secret right there. It's a weird bug, but oh well. It does appear that this is working fine. Let's make sure the dungeons work too. 3-1-1. All right, this is looking okay. All right, this is a good one to check right there, because those the orderings for falling tiles can be very different, unique. Oh, I noticed there's no enemies. Let's turn enemies back on. Make it a little more interesting. One thing to do too is to make sure that, oh man. I noticed this one bug came back where it flickers the... The platform can flicker for a second on the ground. Okay, good. We still have a fix where the Z ordering is correct even if I go up or down these elevators. Alright, this does appear to be working just fine. I'm gonna keep that fix. So that fixes all the... Oh, spiders. Oh, it does look like the door is a little messed up. Oh, I guess that's probably always been there. I'm gonna write that down. Door. Dungeon door east, west has only one door when transitioning. Okay. Okay, so let's go back to the overworld because that's the ordering fix is working good. And that ought to fix this other thing. Here in area creation in create stairs tile, we can put this back to -990. So now the stairs are going to be lower down in the Z ordering. So when you step on the stairs, the hole for the stairs or whatever, you're not ever going to be underneath it. You're always going to be on top of that blackness. And same thing here with when you're walking into an area. This door light in here in the south is actually the light for the stairs. And it's not going to be on top of you. It's more of on the ground coming, flooding in from the light from the from above. Okay, next thing. What's up, Hoo-Hoo Boss? I'm working on the alpha version today. Just fixing up tiny little bugs to get the game playable again. Not that it wasn't playable right now, but it's to get it polished enough to actually be for release. That's kind of what the goal for today is. All right, once more on these mountain tiles, we're creating bushes and plants. And I had this one at negative or at 2000 for Z. I want to actually put that at like -991. Wait. No, -989. So yeah, these bushes are going to be on top of the rocks always, but the player can stand on top of them now. And we'll be able to, yeah, so we can see that these are working okay. They look great. But the player is on top of them. Instead of before, the player would actually, his hat would be underneath this bush right here. Okay, that's good. Now, one thing we do need to work on here is like these little kind of things, these tiles. But there's something else that was important. Hey, what's up, Clock? It's going good, man. Just working on the alpha version today. Getting it polished up for release. To all the backers who backed at the $128 level and above, once again, thank you, backers. This alpha version is going out to you either tomorrow or the next day. All right, so the next most important thing I think is to draw a cool doorway tile for these for the caves. So I'm going to grab the cave entrance as it was, and I'm going to create a newer cave entrance that looks better. Man, what was it called? Rock, stairs. Oh man, I can't see it. Oh, there it is, stairs. All right, rock stairs top, that's right. Rock stairs top, cool. So this is what it was like before. It just like is drawn right into the rocks like that. We're not gonna need this background with it though. Yeah. Azenris, what's up, man? Yeah, it's early today because I got a friend coming over this afternoon, so I wanted to make sure and get a stream in before he came over. And also, I'm in a different room because he's going to be taking that room to sleep tonight. So, yep, coding in the bedroom today. I'm just working on getting the alpha version polished up for release today. So, just lots of tiny little things. One thing right here is I'm working on is this door. So, I love this new look with the mountain tiles. Everything's legit. I'm really excited about it. I did do a whole different kind of look with hexagons last night, and I actually preferred this one without the hexagons. So I'm gonna stick with this for now. And then I'm working on drawing a new cave entrance for these kind of tiles, because as you can see, it doesn't quite line up well for those. So yeah, I'm going to for sure. He plays video games, so I'm actually really excited to finally have a friend over to play this game and actually watching him play firsthand. The three white pixels in the left bottom corner, right bottom corner of this, these are transparent. Yeah, those are actually transparent. They're not white. What's up, Mars of Power? Hey, I just sent off your poster. Actually, I sent it off last Thursday or Friday or whatever, but they finally shipped it, so I sent you an email. You should have your poster sometime. I'm not sure how long it'll take for international delivery, but I saw it was Alessandro's birthday yesterday. Buon cumpleaños. What is it? Buon cumpleaños? All right, cool. Good. Yeah, so I'm gonna take off these rocks and put this whole can of cave entrance onto this other kind of style. Yeah, you're welcome, man. Yeah, I'm excited for you guys to get your posters. Right. It's still his birthday? Nice. Oh, 20 more minutes of birthday time. So cool. Happy birthday again, Alex Pita. You guys who frequent the stream probably know who Alex Pita is. It's his birthday. For another 20 minutes. No, I'm not from Germany. I do have a German name, Weiss. But we pronounce it Weiss for some reason. They change it to Weiss over here. But yeah, it is Weiss. Nathaniel Weiss. yep, so I'm German. I have some German in me, but I'm actually in California. And I've never been to Germany, really. But I'd love to go. I'd love to climb some mountains there. Okay, so I'm gonna take these slices of wall down here. Oh, there it is. Okay. Nice. Oh, you're talking to Mars Power. Oh, all right. Yep. He's Italiano. Okay, good. It's not messed up. Checking this. Making a list. Checking it twice. Find out who's naughty or nice. Is it Italiano? Italiano. Buon compleanno. All right, one more one I want to grab is this bottom. This one. Yeah, 24 by 20. And I'm actually using my mouse to make art today because my graphics tablet is almost dead. Sad face. It's bread day today! Woo! Nice. Tuesday, bread day. Wait, it's... Oh yeah, it's still Tuesday for you. Almost perfect. I'm sure it's really far off. Okay, so now we've got these two tiles. I'm gonna duplicate them again. Actually, this one, yeah, I'll keep that one off. Merge these. Hey, what's up, Slash Life? Momir, what's up? It's Tuesday, yeah, 13 minutes. Oh, you're in the same time zone. You're in the same time zone as Mars Power and Hoo Hoo. Yeah, new room today. I'm in our bedroom because my friend's taking the other room tonight. He's going to be staying with us, so that's why I'm also live streaming a little bit earlier. Oh, compleuno. I hope that's right. Hey, Momir, did you want help with getting Linux to work with Cocoa Studio X? I asked that because Sam would love to help you out. He's the guy that does Rapid Game as well as I. Okay. Yeah, that's what I did. I used the Google Translate tool and then clicked the play button to try and work out how the pronunciation worked. Yeah. Plus a half? I didn't know there was a half. Yeah, I should move there. But then I wouldn't have good internet. So yeah, I'm making a new door for this cave entrance with these new tiles right now. Oh wow, the program node. Really? That's crazy. Oh wow. Okay, well that really changes how Rapid Game should run then. So Sam has not neither of us. So there's Sam and I are both working on Rapid Game, and he's talked about maybe doing a Linux version or whatever, but he was just wondering if you needed help actually getting it set up. So this is good to know that Node.js is the actual command name. But shouldn't it be normal how it installs things? So like if you install Rapid Game should be the same kind of command, right? Like same as on here on a Mac, for example. I can just call Rapid Game. It should be the same. Compleanno. Ah. Compleanno. Holy crap, really? Romania's average? Romania has the fastest internet? Okay, cool. Well, Momir, if you want to get in, if you want any kind of help or whatever, feel free to email me, and I can get your email over to Sam or whatever, or one of us. And my email is nat@wizardfoo.com. That's me. They also drink rocket fuel? Dang, this sounds like a crazy cool country. I'm moving. Screw California. All right, so now that I've got this sort of shape outlined, even though I haven't done the detail work for it, I'm gonna create a slice and make this export all nice so that I can try it out in the game before I do any detail work. So I'm gonna create a new layer in this slice 4. Layer, new layer based slice. Wow. Romanian download index. 68 down, 41 up. That's great. What about the USA? Go to my location. Oh, whoa, we have horrible internet here, apparently. This is why I have to pay it for more. Probably because the average here is that people are not choosing to pay for the upgrades or whatever in their internet. Oh, yeah, no worries. And what's it in Italy? How do I search? I don't know. Well, interesting to note. Okay. Thanks for following, by the way. Okay, so we got this layer. Let's name this layer Mountain cave. Mountain cave door, something like that. All right, so I can save this for the web and it'll export all these frames individually. Make sure all user slices is on. Replace. Now I can use that frame to see if it looks right. Whoa. Oh, you can't even buy. Wow. Yeah, I was trying to look. I couldn't figure out how to search fast enough, so I gave up. Man, it's crazy that Romania has twice as fast internet as here. And I thought this internet was fast. Here we go. So let's change this one to cave. Mountain cave door. Slicing? Oh, yeah, slicing. Yes, in Photoshop. Yes, it's so helpful. You got to make sure when you're slicing it out, when you're saving, that you do that all user slices though. Like when you click save, and if you have a bunch of empty area, like see how this image has a lot of empty bits around it, then yeah, you got to make sure and do all user slices instead of all slices, because otherwise it'll export a bunch of like blank frames. Yeah, I know what you mean. I know what you mean. Yeah, for now I've basically finished the mountain stuff. I'm kind of refining it right now. But yeah, let me show you. It's about to run, so oh, whoops. I left these plants with a blue background. Let's fix that. Ah. Okay, so in that case you'd want to go I don't know. I guess if it would be like something like on a Linux, like you would go, I guess, I haven't tested any of this, but you'd probably want to just go Linux. Something like that. See, none of this has really been written yet. So, first of all, you'd have to check the platforms variable. Yeah. I think it would be something like this. Or, you know, if platform equals Linux, you might want to do, wait, let me get on the same page as you actually. Yeah, so this would be totally different in the pre. You'd have to write, see, a command or a function would have to be written for pre-build Linux or whatever. So it'd have to be something like this. You know, you go var pre-build Linux. And then you'd go SDKs equals probably. Yeah, this would just be platform equals Linux. So this command right here, this SDKs equals, is just. Specifying what was on the command line. So if you were on the command line, you only wanted to build Linux, you could do Linux. Otherwise, you could do Linux and like Android or whatever, something like that. Yeah, this is basically what it is here. This command is basically just yeah, running the different pre-builds for Linux. Yeah, sorry I can't be much more of a help about that right now. I know it's so warm. It's so warm I have a fan on today. I'm still sweating. It's holy hell hot today. Oh, see, that's looking okay, I guess. If you look more rounded, it would be better. Wow, nice work, Slash Life. Okay, cool. Yay, hammocks. Hammocks are good. Okay, so to get this to start looking better, to I'll blend it and put some cool, maybe some like runes around it and stuff to make it look cool. So I'm gonna take this darker color. Merge these. Nice. That sounds really fun. Cool. Good for you, man. You got a cool outdoor life going. Love the outdoors. That's why I'm excited to go on this little vacation with my girl. We're going for 2 weeks. So next week I'm not streaming. The week after that I'm not streaming. But the week after that I'll be back. So, and I will have the alpha version of Songbringer out before all that. Alright, so we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 pixels here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Ah, okay. Who will I watch when you're gone? I got a recommendation for you. If you haven't seen Anton Kudin, you should check out Anton Kudin. He's so good. His art is amazing. His game's called Mega Sphere. He's a cool live streamer too. Yeah, Alpha Build's going to be tomorrow or the next day. Probably the next day. Probably Thursday it'll come out. So, yeah, you'll be getting it. A bunch of other people that back that level are going to be getting it. All right, cool. Whoa, I didn't want to do that. I'm going to do this. I'll keep this info for later. Really? How did I do that? What? I must have answered something a long time ago. What the heck is this? Wow, that's a lot of... Is this must be on a different site. Because it's not here, right? Oh. It's because I've been on other parts of the network, like game dev. Yeah. Yeah, I'm not that great at answering all these. Cool. Yeah, I think you'll like his streams. They're different than mine. You know, like, he doesn't talk and stuff. But his art is so, so good. I watch his stream when I have time. And I'm just like, oh my God. I learn a lot when I watch his art. It's so good. Yeah. Yeah, I never knew that. I never knew they did that. But yeah, I guess that's how you can get a bunch of rep. Just join a bunch of other Stack Overflow networks. Game in the rep. So I'm just adding some texturing now to make this a little more interesting. You can barely see it, but it's there. Yeah, no, definitely I love his game. Yeah. If you haven't seen Megasphere is definitely worth checking out. His game is sort of like a kind of like Metroid inspired, I would guess, but it's a lot of its own unique mechanics too. So, yeah, I'll definitely be buying his game and checking it out because, yeah, I love it. I do. Also, what else do I love? I've mentioned these a lot, but Children of Morta, Hyperlight Drifter, Axiom Verge. There's a lot of rad games out today. Just realize that's upside down. It should be like this. If the light's gonna hit it, it's gonna hit it at the bottom lip. Yeah, this is the alien writing for the there's like a alien alphabet I made for this game. Well, actually I made it a long time ago, but yeah, I'm using it for this game. So a lot of the things are written in this alien alphabet, and Jib can read it, and so Jib will actually translate some stuff for you. Don't know what this says though. What does this say? Alex Pita, happy birthday! Oh, it's not your birthday anymore, but it's still your birthday in our hearts. Just got your poster shipped out. So you should be getting your poster sometime. Sometime this year, I imagine. Let's see how this looks now. Yeah, and in the main menu and everything, you get to see the alien font in a lot of places. Yeah. Yes, I would love to actually do a backstory element for Jib and actually a sub quest just for Jib too. So yeah. He inspires a lot of curiosity, right? And he's actually inspires a lot of love. A lot of people love him. So I really think that he should have his own backstory or something. That looks okay. Except for these tiles right here are kind of messing with it a little bit. Maybe if it wasn't as thick. Yeah. Yeah. I'm getting up there too, man. I'm 35 now. I'll be 36 soon. The year is just like. Maybe he falls in love. That'd be funny. Oh, that's a good idea, Momir. I'm writing that down for the ideas list. Jib's backstory, he falls in love. falls in love with some other robot. To a hot droid chick, yes. I love it. So I'm thinking this should be thinner. Alright, so I'm gonna make sure this thing is also an even, yeah, good, it's got an even width. That helps so your sprites don't ever get lined up on an odd number, because if your sprites are, if you're using pixel perfect rendering and your sprites are on an odd number, then you could potentially have half a pixel and that's just gonna make things look blurry. So it's always good to use these even width pixels, and also height too, if you're aligning things halfway on the height. There we go. I think this might look a little better with it a little more slim. And a little more also independent. With these curvy sort of edges, it kind of gives it the feeling that this is a stone that stands alone. Man, I'm rhyming today. Must be one of those days. All right, so save this for web, try it out. Oh, I don't like it. Yeah, that just doesn't work. Yeah, I guess I should go back to the other one, because this one's kind of lame. Except for maybe the edges. Edges are kind of cool. All right, so I'm saving it right now, and I'm gonna do this edges similar. And then I'll restore my, or revert back to this other version if I don't like it. Yo, what's up, Liar Thief? Thank you once again for all that awesome tutorial you recommended the other week. It's totally transformed my art. I appreciate it, Liar Thief. If anybody else is wants to check out some cool art, Liar Thief is doing some art for his game. Liar Thief, you should post another link, man. It's a cool game to check out. 16-bit style RPG. Yeah, it really did. That was such a good pixel art tutorial. Nice. Look at that. You guys will be impressed. All right, so let's see how this... Oh, it's called Waves of Time now? Or is this a new game you're working on? Oh, yeah, you guys changed the name. Cool. Waves of Time. See what I'm talking about? This is some rad 16-bit art right here. Wish I could zoom in. That just says adventure right there. Beep, 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 beep. Ah, okay. Hey, what's up, QLab? Waves of Time. That's very definitely more epic for sure. But I liked Llama Quest. Alright, yeah. That does look better. Let me wider. Okay, so what I'm going to do is make sure... I'm not going to do this now because this isn't critical to getting the alpha build working, but what I'll do later is make sure that these rocks can't ever... But there's at least three rocks wherever there's a cave entrance like that. Yeah. Ah, cool. Hey, what's up, Prism? Okay, so yeah, that's good. I'm gonna leave that as it is, and I can delete this other one that just didn't really work out. I don't need these anymore either. And I wanna do a little more whoop-de-doops here and here. That's it. Yes, Fedax, of course, man. Share, please. All right, Slash Life. Good night, man. All right, the next critical thing on this list, I'll work on the art for this later. I'll improve that even more. But the next thing I want to do is make sure that the cave entrances for other types of areas are working. And we're going to need to find one. Like, I think this might be one right here. Let's find where the store is supposed to be. Oh, no worries, man. No worries. Thank you. So where is the first store in this world? Oh, it looks like it's right there. Or here, possibly there. Let's try there. So we'll go to 000. I think that is where the store is. Yeah, the plants are looking all right now. Yeah, all of it I think still needs a little love, a little more work, maybe one more day, you know, and it'll all be looking super tits. See, this looks weird for sure. The plants on top of it, that's not gonna do. Nice. Nice, man. Nice pack of cigs. What's to stay in there? Stu-da-da-da for the real. Cool. Actually, that's not bad, man. That's really good. That's actually pretty good pixel art. I know, it totally needs zoom, right? I wish I could zoom all that. Yo, greetings, professional novice. What's up, man? Okay, so what we were just looking at there, we saw that cave entrance that looked just kind of horrible. So I'm going to make sure there's no plants near stairs. Create mountain tile. So we can do like a distance to stairs. Is it command plus two finger pinch? I'd have to get up my... Oh, yeah, that does work. Cool. Nice trick. Smoldering KL for real. Is that what it says? So you can tell that it's blurred it because of probably either you made a blurry picture or it just blurred it automatically somehow by resizing it or something. Okay. Yeah, so distance to stairs. Float dist equals this get tile distance from the current point to the stairs. So if distance is like greater than 2, let's see if that works. It might have, but I thought that the rest of the text was still crisp. I don't know. Yeah, alright, so now we don't have any plants around this cave entrance. But as you can see, it doesn't really look that good. It looks weird, at least. It doesn't really gel with these sides right here. Oh, one thing, the actual, it's not colored right. Let's set the color correct. Hey, what's up, Doc? I just fixed up your poster today. Your custom poster, signed and everything, ready to go out to you. To the duck! To the duck! Yeah! Anyways, I would show you what's inside here, but I already packed it up for you, and I don't want to get it out and mess it up, so. But yeah, I'll be sending this off tomorrow, so I don't know how long it'll take to get to you, but it's on its way soon. Yeah, I know. I don't want to do so much of a hard entrance there. Yeah, I would like to make it smooth and look really good for sure. Yeah, the IDE I'm using here is Xcode. Yeah. Yeah, Xcode does do C++ for sure. Does C++, Objective-C, C. I think those are the only languages it does. I don't know. Might do more. So yeah, the first of all, I'm gonna get this to be green, the right color for this stairs entrance. And then oh. Man, I can't even type today. Color 3B there. So I should make it green and at least blend that way. No, I'm not sitting. I mostly stand. Yeah, I mostly stand to work. Yeah, there you go. Perfect. Oh yeah, Swift, right. Yeah, of course. It does. Nice, right on. Cool. So let's see if that color blending makes that look a little bit better. This is a really good area to test out this cave entrance on because it's really revealing how it can look when it's on a corner like this. So first thing that's got to change is this, the edge. So the edge can't have that darkness. And it needs to be flat on the bottom. Yeah. Visual Studio Code, yeah. Thanks to you guys, I'm informed about all this kind of stuff. Usually I'm just like clueless about everything that's going on in the world. Figure out what this says. I want this to actually say something. So we need font, an alien font. Ah. Huh. It's on your pie? Sweet. So the character is sort of like L is a B. So it says B. BL. That's triangle A B C D E F. That's BLF. So I don't think this is saying anything. BLF. What's that one? E? I think it's a. I think it is an E. A, B, C, D, E. B, L, F, E. Doesn't say anything. It's funny. No, yeah, it doesn't work on Visual Studio. Now I should be, right? Yeah, I don't know how to do anything. I even have it tattooed on my wrists, and I still don't know what it says. I mean, I know what these words say, but a fool's doo-doo. Yeah, I'm definitely a C++ guy. Yeah. I don't ever want to buy into a certain platform, a certain company's language, you know what I mean? Like Swift, yeah, they're making it open source now, but how many years is it going to take them to actually make Swift a truly cross-platform language? Maybe never. Maybe they might not ever do it actually. You know, this might just be a gesture on their part where they're kind of making an open source language or whatever, which, you know, like for example, Objective-C never ever really made it to be that popular of a compiled language. It finally made it into GNU, you know, G++ and all that, GCC. But, you know, it took years and years and years for them to actually finally get that into GCC. So how long is it going to take them to get Swift to be compiled in multiple different places? Probably a long time, if ever. And so, yeah, I always believe that it's great to be able to write your game in one language and then port it or, you know, build it for a million different other languages. So C++ is one of the most portable languages there ever was and ever probably ever will be. So that's why I write it all my game code in C++, because it's just easy to port. And it's also incredibly fast. Oh. Holy crap, I didn't know Visual Studio. Oh, this is Visual Studio Code, huh? Look at that. Wow. PHP, Java, dang, there's a lot supported here. It's pretty rad. Brotherhood of Locomotive Firemen and Engine Men. All right, we'll leave it like that then for now. At least it's explained. Oh, that's coloring only? Oh. All right. We've got to get back to the most important stuff here, which is getting this to work in multiple places. Okay, let's export that now that it looks a little better, or hopefully looks better mixed in now. Yeah. What's R? I don't even know there was a language called R. Right, cool. See, that's a little bit better. In fact, I could probably do a single pixel out of it on the corner, on the corners. Yeah, so that blends a lot better. I'm gonna leave it something like this. Whoops, I just closed Xcode accidentally. Yes, I've heard of this one. I've heard of this one. And it looks exactly like it sounds. Yeah, let's do one more pixel actually. Right there and there. Yeah, it's a bed. Yeah. I'm in the bedroom today because I got a friend coming in tonight, staying with us. So, yep, I'm once again, I've lost my work room. But it's cool. I'll get my work room back tomorrow. Okay, you know what? That's looking okay. Oh, that's bad. I just noticed that you're not occluded by these anymore. So that was a bad move, making their Z ordering here on the ground. Okay, so I do need to fix this so that the Z ordering for these is actually using one. Okay, so that means I'm gonna need to do some special stuff for these. And check this out, I can't get in that cave entrance either. So that should be fixed. So lots of things to fix here. Yes, yeah, Fidastics. Everything in the game is randomly generated. You use six letters when you first start the game. I'll actually show that off. I haven't showed that in a while, so I might as well show you guys the menu. But basically, once you give it six letters, it generates an entire world based on those six letters. So like, here's the overworld it generated. Here's level one it generated. Here's level two, level three. So it generates an entire world based on those six letters. It doesn't. So yeah, it's a lot like Zelda, but when you enter in, when you start a game, you've got either regular mode or permadeath. Permadeath is just you die. When you die, you're dead. You can't start again. And so yeah, you enter your six letters, and that generates an entire world for you. So yeah, I'm gonna quit out and just keep on continuing with my current game. So okay, the first thing, let's fix the mountain tiles once back, put their Z's back to one, which is gonna put them automatic Z ordering so that they're ordered in front of the player when they should be. So I'll have to figure out some other way to handle the other issues that arise from these being up high like this. So start there. Yeah, totally. Yeah, I'm excited to get it out to you guys. Alpha version, probably Thursday sometime. And it's probably going to come out on Steam, so it'll be a Steam release of the alpha. What's up, T? So make sure you got Steam downloaded. Probably already do. Okay, yeah, so now the player can be occluded by these mountains. That's good. So it can. Okay, not that one plant though. That needs to be fixed. All the plants actually are messed up now. So the plants need also to be Z of one. Oh, thanks, Novice. Yep, I redid the pre-ordering, so you can buy into the beta version now. But if you do want to get the alpha version, I could totally honor that if you just get the if basically if you're gonna back or pre-order at the $64 level, and then you can send me $64 more, and then I'll owe you a poster as well. So I'll ship you out a poster. Even though those were meant only for the Kickstarter backers, I am, you know, if you're gonna drop 128 bucks, I will still honor that and allow you to get the poster and the alpha access. So that's better. It's better, but the plants are they were being occluded by things in front of them. So I'm going to try one little trick to put their Z order one higher. So I'm going to get the render component. And set flags or equals K flag Z, no, K render. Render. Dude, why is my autocomplete so slow? Z like minus one. Z plus one. This might work. We'll see. All right. Yes, tell me it worked. These plants need to be... No, okay. They're not working because the plants in front of them or the rocks in front of them are way higher in their Z order. So I'm going to have to put these at 2,000. And that means the player's head is going to go underneath these plants, which is okay, I guess. Yeah, there. So what will happen now is, yeah, man, this kind of sucks that the jib can be occluded now by these rocks. But I guess that just means I have to program him to not go inside the rocks. So some of this stuff is not going to be perfect for the alpha release, but one day it'll all get sorted out. Okay, so we need to be able to see this cave entrance. That'll be good. And... and be able to walk into it, of course. Okay. We got this. Let me get a drink of water, though, real quick. I'm getting dry mouth here.
It's a hot day.
Okay, so I think I know what it is. The stairs are at like negative 990. Yeah. So if area pause.z is 0, then we need to do a regular z ordering. Otherwise, negative 990. That'll put it visually on top. Yeah, that's great. I heard it's hot. Everybody else is saying it's hot there too right now, which is crazy. I thought it was just us. Which, you know, I wouldn't wish this on anyone. Like, we've had so much heat for so long that, like, we have very little water in California. We actually are in somewhat of a serious drought, so. Okay, cool. So it's visually there. Now we just need to make it so it's actually there with its tile. Wait a minute. If I just return from this method, then I can show myself that I'm actually in the right method. When was the last time it rained? Man. Germany's a drought too? When was the last time it rained? It actually did rain once or twice in April, I think. But we should have had rain like from in January, February, March, all those months, we had just nothing but sunshine, which is kind of cool. You know, it's nice to have the nice weather, but we've seen rain. Wait a minute. So I returned from the stairs tile, and did it have it? Yeah, okay. Does that proves that is definitely a stairs tile? So why can't I get in there? Oh, it's flooding again in Texas? Damn, dude, the weather is so weird. Oh man, so nice. Oh. You literally are ginger. Yeah. Wow. Okay, I'm so curious. I'm gonna turn on the debug mode because there should not, if it's using a stairs tile, there should not be a collision component. Yeah. It's just dry here. It's nice and, it's always been a nice warm state, but it's, we've gotten good rain in the winter, you know? And now we're not getting any rain in the winter. So it looks like there is a collision tile there. So somehow it's putting a mountain tile and a cave tile. How could it be putting a door and a mountain tile in the same place? Like I can verify this. If I turn off the collision component here, I should still not be able to go down. And then if I turn off the collision component on the mountain tile, then I should be able to go in there. Yeah, so we can't get in there. Mountain tile. Rec style, turn off collision. Yeah, so we're good to go. Maybe it's the, oh man, it might be putting a collision component in the wrong place or something. No, it can't be. And this certainly is weird. So I know for sure that it's putting a mountain tile and a stairs tile in the same position. And technically, it should only be able to put one tile in one place. So either the stairs tile is in the wrong. I'm going to set a breakpoint. For the stairs tile. Let's see what its position actually is. So like auto P equals K tile pause. Yo, what's up, Beckloff? Yeah, I remember you were mentioning that about how having like a nice a website to. Yeah, really just the best thing to do is just email them to me for now. Yeah, sure. Yeah, if you want to do a YouTube video and email that to me, whatever, that'd be awesome. Yeah. Yeah, just email me, I guess. I'll probably, when it gets to the actual beta stage, I'll probably make it, maybe I'll make a better system for that. I don't know. It depends on how many bugs there really are and how overwhelming that gets. Okay, I'm going to verify what position this stair style is. And then verify the mountain. Okay, so we've got one stairs tile at 13, 12, in a position of 270, 144. All right, so I'll set another breakpoint inside to create the mountain tile and just verify this if this really is putting two tiles in one place. In Slack, what's Slack? I haven't heard of Slack. Be less busy. I like it. All right, cool. Good idea. I'll check this out. Slack. Cool. Uh-huh. Nice. Mm-hmm. Cool. Your secret projects. All right, so we got this rectangular style one here. Set a breakpoint there. If... Oh, wait. Set a breakpoint here. If p.x equals 270 and p.y equals 144. All right, so I can't really believe this is happening, but this might be happening. Ah. All right, it looks like it's either slowed it down so much with this breakpoint, or it crashed. Oh, there it goes. So yeah, it did. It just broke. Position is 270, 144. Let's set this to all local variables. We've got x is 13, y is 12. How in the hell did it do this? Oh, I think I got an idea. It might have actually put, you might be creating a stairs tile manually. Let's see if that's the case. Oh, yeah, it's manually creating a stairs tile. Okay, well, good. I'll now be consolidating these two types of stair creation into one method so this never happens again. Right. So I'm gonna be right back. Take a little break again. Some more water. Right, so this was a bad move anyways to have two different ways to create stairs. So there should only be one way to create stairs. It shouldn't be this one. We're going to use a stairs tile. Wait. Let's make sure this can't be secret. Yeah, this is not secret. Okay. Oh, wait. Oh, it is. Can set an exit hidden. Okay, so the hidden exits need to have a rock tile in front of them. That's right. Yeah, I'm going on vacation next week. So I'm actually going to be streaming tomorrow and the next day, Thursday. And then from Friday, I'm off. So yeah, for 2 weeks, I'll be on vacation. And there won't be any live streams until I get back on like July. What's the date in July? Dude, this calendar sucks. Yeah, so we're gone the 6th, 7th. Yeah, so I'll be back July 20th. I know it's a long time, but it's only 2 weeks. Daily live streams from the beach. Yeah, today I'm doing nothing again. Yeah, but actually, I hope to heal my hand of its tendonitis. These 2 weeks off with no typing is actually going to be pretty healthy. And also, I'm really excited to get a fresh brain for my whole this whole game, because sometimes you can get kind of stuck into a certain zone, and it's really nice to take a complete break and come back to things with a completely fresh mind. So I'm really excited about that too. Yeah, so there's two ways. I see why there's two ways to do it, and there really shouldn't be. There should only be one. So I'm going to take away the stairs tile. There's K tile stairs. And that's just, I'll take that one away because we already got the other way to doing it. So I know, yeah, it will be nice to take a break. Yeah, I've been working nonstop actually before this project. So it's been a long time since I've actually taken a vacation. I guess the last time was Burning Man. Last year we took a week off for that. And that's like the last week of August. So yeah, it's been almost a year. So 2 weeks is going to be a nice long time actually. My girlfriend's never taken a 2 week vacation before. She's only taken a week long vacation, which is crazy, right? All right, so when we're creating this pattern home, we've already got the stairs position, so we can do this stairs, I think it's position equals, yeah, it's crazy, right? Now, if the current tile, we can just go like this, continue. So that won't put a rock by the stairs. Okay. Okay, so this is the cave entrance right here. So we can just set the stairs pause. Is there a dot set method? No. Okay, it's fine. Int vec2 W20. I know, right? Yes, someone does. I was thinking about that the other day. I was like, man, somebody needs to freaking write some awesome voice recognition software for coding. Like, totally for coding. What's up, Gladiar? Ooh, nice. Right on. Yeah, Gladiar, this is C++, man. C++. C++ 11. Forgot if this was... Yeah. There. Okay, that one's good. So this is where it's converting rocks to bushes, and it's making sure it's not near the stairs position. So oh, really? They need to do this for everyone. Dude, that's awesome. Okay, I'm gonna check this out later. Of course, I can't check that out later. Second one on the page? Ah.
This is Tavis Rudd, and he's going to be talking to us about cool. Using Python to code by...
Oh, well, I got them both now. We're good. I'm going to explore that, because that would be cool if it was actually possible to do it on a Mac right now with Xcode somehow. It'd be like, computer... How far are we away from the nearest star? I know, right? And then every night I go through and check them all out. Actually, some really rad links you guys share. Seriously, like No Man's Sky, that was a rad link. Oh my god, that game looks awesome. Oh, and the Mar.io, whoever shared Mar.io, that was really cool. Mar.io is this AI that's actually a neural network that somebody wrote that plays Mario. It's pretty cool. It learns how to play Mario. Yeah, but it better be within 1 year. We need to have all of our code write itself. So here's where we don't need a stairs tile anymore. So we're just gonna use the other method, the manual method, to create a stairs tile after we've created everything else. We need to make sure this one thing where you actually create a cave entrance to... Maybe it's the order. I am. No, I love to let go of things, actually. I'm kind of the opposite of a hoarder. Oh, okay, let's just see if this works. It's probably not going to work for this situation, but it probably will work for the home situation. So yeah, we still don't have this tile here, but let's see. Let's put the player back to home. What is 0 divided by 0? Computer, draw me a game, yes. This is kind of funny, but I don't even know how to use Siri. You just hold down the home key? Oh, you do. Okay. Siri, what is 0 divided by 0?
Okay.
She just said okay. Siri, what is 0 divided by 0? That is so rad. Oh my god. Oh, that's so great. Thanks, Doc. I'm going to show that to people. Yes, that was great. Imagine if you have 0 cookies and you divide them by 0. You still have 0 cookies. That's awesome. Okay, so yeah, is there a door? Is there a cave door at the very beginning? Does it work? Okay, it's missing. Because we don't have it yet. Alright, so we need a stairs. I thought I set the stairs position for this one. Area. Oh, I commented it out. No wonder. Yeah, the cookie monster is still sad. You have 0 friends. Oh, I put it on the wrong side. So it's got to flip that. Okay, so in area patterns... Pattern home, here it is. Pattern home, stairs vision. If we're flipped. Okay, that's really odd. It just... By adding that code, it unflipped everything. Oh. Oh, I think I know what it was. I can set this to a float. Yeah, interesting. Yeah, I know to do it right would be really, really awesome, right? Because like it needs to recognize what you're talking about in context and be able to write code for your language. So yeah. What's Atom? Is that a language? Hey, Felix. Welcome. Dude, it flipped it again. It's so weird. Why would it flip everything? What? What? Oh, cool. Right, so if I don't do this, how is this changing everything? Is it that? So confusing. Wait a minute, what if flipped is all wrong? That happened to me yesterday, actually. I got auto-logged out all weird. So there's flipped. Here's flip false. Let's see if this is actually working. Yeah, this is working. Oh, I see what's up. I got it. This code is wrong. This is an integer vector. Man, I can't believe my own integer vector class just killed me right there. Stairs position equals intec. There we go. So now if flipped is just normal, it should work. Ah, what the hell? Oh, okay. So everything in this whole method here is based on this stairs position. This is probably it. I know, right? I do. I'm writing crazy code here. Back in time. Oh, but I need this code. Damn. All right. Okay, so we'll just take this one, make it effect 2 stairs pause. All right, Lighter Thief. Good night, man. Thank you. I'll get this. I got it. Now it's even worse. What the hell? What the hell, man? K is just for a constant. It came from Objective C, that's the style, but it's also something Google recommends doing. Prefixing all your constants with a K. Yeah. It's part of the Google standards. So I don't feel so odd doing it. But yeah, for a while I did feel odd doing it. Yeah, all uppercase for sure. That's how I used to do it too. Back in the old days. Dude, I have no idea why this is bugging out on me like this. It must be this stuff. Near stairs. Yeah, that's got to be it. So stairs pause is compared to X and not the flipped X. So we never want to flip X. That would make sense. So we'll do stairs position like this. And set the stairs right here. So if flipped, else, Flip false. Everything should be on the left this time, or the main stuff with stairs. Yeah, okay, it's there. I set flip to be true. Hold on. What the heck was... Projects... Area creation... Area patterns... Oh, see, was it in Vec2? Okay. Man, I think I finally understand. Duh. Man. All right, set a breakpoint. All right. Flipped. True. Stairs pause. 6:16. Now, after flipped. No, because yeah, that's a good question. Very, very good idea. But there's an operator equals for vec2s for my integer vector class. Yeah. So it'll handle it correctly, and we should see that by stepping over this, and we should see that this stairs position. Oh no, I just got rid of my variables. Dude, I'm having a weird day. Code is not my friend right now. Okay, here. This stairs position where is it? Ah, there it is. It's 0, 0. And if I set it to this vec2, all right, yeah, you're right, it's wrong. Good call, Azenris. Hey, what's up, Seaman Roses? Good call, Azenris. You totally nailed it, man. That was it. So it needs to be stairs position equals stairs pause. So this is basically I'm using an integer vector 2 in a really weird way in this function, and it's causing me to fumble like crazy. So basically, stairs position dot x needs to be set to something special, and not use the operator equals override. So actually, I'm gonna set a breakpoint there and make sure this works. Yes, Azimris does. Does get the high five of the day. Psh, psh, psh. High five. That was 3 high fives in a row. Okay, so yeah, we got stairs position 0, 0. Now it's 6:16. And if it's flipped, it's 14:16. Alright, that should work. Yeah, and it did. We finally have the stairs again. Thanks to Azenris. Okay, one little change I'm gonna make here is I'm gonna put the stairs actually one frame down, or one tile down, and that will allow the outside of it to blend in a little bit better. Yes, there we go. Now we've got an outside that's looking good. Actually, yeah. Oh, yeah, it works all right. We got tiles around it. Yeah. This looks okay. Okay, so next thing, let's go make sure the other one's working. That one is at 000. So I think what the one thing it's going to need is to make sure it doesn't place a a rock tile. Yeah, see, I can't walk in here because there's a rock tile there. So we need to do in pattern quadrant. Where does it get its stairs, Boz? Thanks, Fiddlebits. Do I think I'm good right now? Yeah, if you want to ask me a question, I can try and answer. I am kind of in the middle of debugging these other issues, but I'll give it a chance. Wait, I got to make sure that works still. Yeah, okay, it's working. And then if I set it to false manually, it should still work. All right. And you guys feel free to post issues too, or you know, you can post issues to the Rapid Game page. If you don't understand something, I'm happy to help there. And also Sam, who's familiar with the project, he'd be happy to help too. Good. Okay, that's working. Yay. Next one, we need to make sure that when it places the stairs position for secrets. Oh, I think I realized where it is. It's in place stairs. Place stairs. Yeah. Oh, this is Sam. Duh. What's up, Sam? You can tell my head is a little bit not all the way 100% right now. Nice, right on. Good. Okay, so if it's going to place a stairs position, then it's going to need to make sure that at that current stairs position, there is no... there's no rock tile, so set tile at x, y, k tile, none. Stay hydrated. Yes, I know. I gotta get some more water. My brain is like at 40%. Heat wave. Okay, so let's hope this works. If it's not a hidden stair style, then it should carve out a space for the stairs. So that's 0. Yeah, all right. So can I go down these stairs? Yeah, I can finally go down the stairs. That's awesome. Okay, so that was one of the critical bugs in this version. So the alpha version is now way better. Yeah, Nano, what's up, man? Yeah, I'm in a different part of my house. This is our bedroom because my friend's staying in the workroom tonight. So it's the workroom is today a guest room. The square block, let's see. Yes, yeah, it's a really, really busy couple days for me because I'm getting the alpha version finished, and then I got to go on vacation. So I'm trying to scramble to finish this alpha version before I leave. So what's the black square, huh? What black square? Where? Oh, at the right side of the screen? Oh, yeah. There's a couple blocks that are still totally square shaped, and I haven't fixed those yet. But they're a visual thing, so that's not as critical as like these more code issues. But I think I know what you're talking about, where there's a couple, sometimes there's a couple of square tiles. Oh, this one's weird. Just gonna go ahead and put some stairs there. Yeah, alpha version. Oh, on the other startup screen? Yeah, yeah, it was probably one of those square, just a square rock tile that I need to refine by using more. I need more of these kind of things here. I need to write some more shapes for those specific needs. What's left to finish in the alpha? As many of these bugs as I can finish. So I've got a whole list of like, you know, all of these would be nice to finish before I release the alpha version, but there's probably no way in hell I'm going to get those done in the next 2 days. I could probably get maybe this many done, like 20 or so issues. We'll see. Cool. Thank you, Mr. Laguma. Awesome. I really appreciate that you saying that because I respect your artistic aesthetic. Am I part of this chat anymore? Hello? Looks like I'm a part of the chat. I don't know. Okay, so yeah, we can climb down those stairs, but what the heck? Why the heck were there stairs in the middle of nowhere? Like over here. There's like just some random stairs right here. Yeah. Well, there's only one tile that does that, and that's the stairs position. So if I comment out the stairs, it should be that. So that means it has a stairs position in some weird place where water is covering it up. So water. Yeah, so now we got no stairs there. No stairs here. Yeah, so it must be the water is covering it up. Yeah, the plans definitely need work. The visuals, all of this needs work. This is kind of a rough draft. And since I'm shooting to have the alpha version out by Thursday, I'm probably not going to have time to do all the visual details that I would like to do for this stuff. So, yeah. I'll be doing some more detailed work on it all after I take a vacation. So, I'm doing this alpha version, then vacation next week and the week after. Then I'll be back and I'll be doing a lot more details. I'd really love to do a waterfall too, you know, homage to Zelda. Yeah. I could actually. Cool. Good. I'm glad. I'm glad you think that. I could actually go and do a function where it doesn't, or I can just make sure that it doesn't add any water. Yeah, let's make sure when it's adding water, it doesn't put anything near the stairs tile. Yeah, waterfall should be really fun. Fun and easy stuff. Okay, so if we get the tile distance from the current point to the stairs pause. And the stairs pause is not zero. And that's like less than two, and we'll continue. So it doesn't put any water. Hello, Sammy Lots. What's up? You want a TIE fighter in a bottle? Good call. Good call. Thanks to Button Masher Bros for that awesome bit of humor. If you guys don't know what we're talking about, the Button Masher Bros did a video on Songbringer, and they called all the butterflies mini TIE fighters. I like that idea. That's cool. Yes, it would. All right, that didn't work. Okay, I guess I could do. I mean, this works if I do less than. Yeah, uh-huh. It's on the Kickstarter page. There you go. These are great. Button Masher Bros. And then also, if you haven't checked out Randomized Users, this is funny too. But that link's right here on the Kickstarter page if you want to check it out. But the Button Masher Bros are hilarious. All right, good night, Sam. What the heck is this? This goes right back to that point in the overworld. This has got to be a bug. Yeah, because this level is not even supposed to have stairs. So how did it get stairs? And it was weird, right? That was super weird. This is a bug that needs to be dealt with. Let's make sure. I'm not going to comment this one in for now. Actually, well, I'll leave it in. I know, yeah. It doesn't even have to do anything, right? It is kind of funny. Okay, so either the stairs position is starting off not zero. Well, no, that's not possible. Because it's or it's a feature, right? I think if I'll look for stairs position everywhere. I'm looking for places where it would set the stairs position. Pattern Home does, of course. Pattern Cave does. This is no longer used. Pattern Secret. Yeah, that's a cool idea. Yeah. Cool. I'm going to keep that in mind because that might be a pretty cool thing because, you know, I could maybe make them look a little bit different, like they would have some kind of like portally shimmering look or something like that. And then it would kind of explain that this is, you know, a special stairs. Yeah. Or trap. Okay, so when I did that, does it say secret? Secreted. It would be 10. Yeah, so it didn't say secret at 10. So it must not have been this one. So after looking through all of that, there's like only a couple places that set the stairs position. So I'm gonna first set the player's point right there so I can start there. Yeah, oh yeah. Possibly. I think it probably is this one right here, this play stairs method, because this gets called for just about every Oh, see what it could be is it might be something that has an exit destination. Okay, yeah, so I'm gonna set a breakpoint here. No, let's set a breakpoint here. No. Yeah, I really want to set a breakpoint there. And see if area pause dot x equals 0 or 1, area pause dot y equals 0. Area pause dot z equals 0. Because I think what's probably happening is it has an exit destination, and that's what gets it into this. And then that would explain. Okay, so this exit dest, 000, that's probably what it is. So the isValid method is checking if it's -1, -1, -1. Is it 3D? No, it's not 3D. It's totally 2D. That's a cool compliment, though. Yeah, I guess technically it is. It does have three-dimensional math and stuff like that, but the graphics are entirely 2D. Yeah, so because this is a 000 exit destination. Oh, and that's why it warped back to the point on the map at 000. That totally explains it, yeah. So, yeah, it's going to get into this function because it has that exit destination. Pretty much every single point on the entire map would have some stairs that would lead to nowhere. Okay, so that explains it. Yeah, I guess you would call it 2.5D. It's a good. That's the most accurate way to describe it. So when the, at least when areas are initialized, they should have an exit destination. That's invalid. Okay, so that should fix that bug. That's a good one to have fixed. I think the next thing I want to do is make it so the store is closer to the start. Yeah, I get that a lot. I think it's really just the monitor, man. I think it's just my monitor, how it shines. Sometimes it's bright, sometimes it's dark. But I do get out a lot. I go and I do yoga outside a lot, so that's why I'm pretty much tan all the time. Okay, good. So that does not have a... Wow, well, that's cool. I'm glad I do fix them fast. I feel like I'm fixing them slow. What's up, Pema? Yeah, okay, so that worked. So now I want to make it so all of the store is always really close to the start. What am I doing? Wow, 2.5 hours stream already. Well, I guess I'll do 15 more minutes. My friend might be arriving soon. But I'll keep streaming until he arrives, or at least for 15 more minutes. So let's try and make it so the player position or the store position is always close to the home. So that would be in world, where it places points of interest. That's actually in maze, I think. Maze, where it sets up... places flags. Here we go. Yeah, so the only requirement on placing points of interest is that they don't have any flags. So, and it also helps to have them be far apart from each other. Yeah, Vic2 is part of Cocos 2DX. Yeah, it's not built into C++, but it is built into the Cocos 2DX game engine I'm using. Okay, so here's the thing. I want to make a list of possible places to put the for the interest, and then I want to make sure the list has positions that are far enough. From each other. I guess I could do that. Filter that. Just make the list and then filter it. Nice, Ethan. What's up? Nice. Yes, it is. Okay, so I can make a list of possible Okay, so vector pause. Possible. These are the choices we're gonna have, and then I'll loop over every area that might possibly work, and push it back. Whoops. Possible that push back. Oh, actually, this needs to be a sorted pause. Or sorted vec2, that works. Sorted vec2. So we're going to push back this and also the distance from this to the home. So possible to push back, sorted vec2. I'm pretty sure there's a constructor for this. For, yeah, pause and dist. Alright, so we got vec2, x, y, and the distance is going to be, okay, let's save this. So vec2, p, x, y, this is p, and this is p dot distance to the home, which is vec2, start x, start y. There. So now we can sort this list as well. So let's do that. Sort. Is this the sort method I usually use? Sort. Standard sort. Yeah. Something like this. Area. Here we go. Yeah. Possible. But begin. Sort possible. Yeah. That's all it needs. Sort possible. So if possible.size, we're going to sort possible. Nice. Good job, Nano. Right on. So we're sorting it possible.in, possible.begin. So there. Now this is now what we have is a list of all the possible places we could put a place of interest. And now we need to make sure this list is far, each point is far enough from the others. So we need to loop over all the points and then loop over all the points again. So we wanna do like this. We can use the iterator for this first loop. Auto it equals possible. Begin. It's not equal to possible.in. And we're not going to do anything to increase the iterator because we're going to do that here because we might be deleting it. So, get closest other point. So for auto ref pair, or no, auto ref I in possible, so we'll do float closest dist. Now, we're going to get the distance from this point to all other points. So, float dist, well, we make a vec2. Oh, we got that. Already got a vec2. So, float dist equals it pause dot distance to I dot pause. If it pause equals I dot pause, Continue. Now, if dist is less than closest, dist, closest dist equals dist. If really close, then delete this possible point. So if the distance, we got closest distance to another feature, for example, it's like less than 3 screens, maybe 2, might have to check this out here, then we're going to delete this this iterator. So it equals possible.erase it. Otherwise, we increment the iterator. There. So let's see if this works. So yeah, we want to check size again, and then if it works, all right, this is where we're going to be filling up the array. So count equals 0. Now we're going to loop over all the points again. And set some interest points. So this is set flag at i.pause.x, i.pause.y, kflag interest, count plus plus. And if count is greater than or equal to k max overworld interests, break there. So this should be all we need for all this again. There. It's a totally different kind of algorithm, but it should put the points of interest close to the beginning and far enough away from each other, if this works. Yeah, Arcane, it does matter. When it's alone on one line, you're right, it shouldn't matter, but it does matter when you're using classes. So a variable like int I would totally matter, but if it were an iterator, which is a class, then it's different because you're doing it one way versus the other. I would recommend checking this out on like Stack Overflow. I know this has been answered like a million times on Stack Overflow. So do a search on Stack Overflow, and it'll give you a lot better answer than I'm giving you right now. But there's definitely a difference. Yes, that's it right there, basically. Azenris has it. Azenris is amazing at C++. So, yeah. Okay, so what I'm going to do here is I'm going to make sure that this is... I'm going to set a breakpoint when it's doing all this. And just see if it... I'll walk through it and see if it works. Yeah, Nano, that's for constants. K for constant. I know it should be C for constant, but it came from Objective-C that we started using K. And then some companies do it, and I've kept that habit too. Okay, so we've got a list of possible points that is many, many long. Wow. There's 90 possible positions. We've got like 0, 0 is a position, 9, 0, distance is 2, distance is 1, cool. So now it's sorted them. No longer, yeah, there's 9, 1, distances are a little bit more flexible. Let's step in. All right, so the distance between this point and the other one, what's... So we got... its position, it item pause is 6, 0, and then I is 8, 1. And so the distance between them is... 2.2, if that is, yeah, okay. I think this might work. And then run it to here. We've got a closest distance of 1. Okay, so I'm just going to run all this until after it's done, and we'll see what this does. So, there. Run to there. We'll see how many positions we actually got from this. 2 positions. Okay, so that didn't really work. It filtered out everything but 2 positions, which are way far apart from each other. Okay, so that needs to improve somehow. Oh, is that what it is too? Yeah, this is Kets, this is C++, not C#. Hey, what's up, Proton? What's up, man? All right. So that almost worked, but we got some closest distances that are probably too close. So let's do a closest dist of 2.0. Might need to change that to 1.5, and we'll see what how many possible positions we have there. Okay, so now after sorting and after doing all this, oh good, yeah, now we got 7 possible positions. Still not that many. And that's not accurate anymore. We got a possible position at x0, 0, but that should have been sorted. We got 8, 7. 8, 7 is actually close. Oh, wow. So all these other points. Oh, man. Well, I think I might have to save finishing this algorithm for later on, because I want my buddy to be able to play this today, and I know he's going to be showing up in like 5 minutes or so. So I might skip all this. Let's set a breakpoint here and see what this is doing, if it's creating a good enough array. We've got possible point here. Yeah, 6, 0, that's a good point for the beginning. 8, 1, that's a good enough point. Cool. Yeah, I'm gonna skip this whole complexity of making sure that the positions are not close to each other. Let's do this and that, and then we'll run it. We can look at the overall map and see if it's buggy or what. Okay, invalid interest flag number 9. Oh, did I do? There, set that. This is Kets, yeah, C# is based on C++. Okay, that did change the whole algorithm for generating this world, but oh, that's, I didn't change the whole algorithm, it just changed that one room. Okay, cool. So let's see where it put those everything here in the overworld. Ah, see, it just piled all the points of interest right around the entrance. But that's okay. I'll make it better. Oh, that's kind of annoying, actually. But let's see what it looks like when we're playing it. And also, I need to turn on preview mode because the screen's going to be too big. So preview build 1, that's going to set a smaller world. Oh, nice. Jax Dragon, what's up, man? I don't know. You have to do a Google search on that. I prefer to do single-threaded games myself. Okay. All right, so this is a smaller world. This is a store. What is this? It's the store. Okay, we found the store. It's really, really close to the very beginning. What else is around here? We got a blank room. That's kind of cool. We don't want everything to be full of stuff. What's this? Why is there. So this room has nothing. Why does it even have an entrance? Oh, that might be the droid smith. Okay, let's turn off the droid smith's bit of his world. I get what's going on here. So if we're gonna set only if n equals zero, that's gonna be the very first interest is the only one which has a secret pause or a stairs. What's up, Vitality? It's going great, man. I'm almost done with my stream here. I'm just kind of getting an alpha build ready so my friend can play it tonight. And then the alpha build is going to come out probably on Thursday. So everyone who backed the Kickstarter at a pretty high level, they're getting a version of the game to play. So that's going to be cool to get that out. And then next week I'm going to be on vacation. So it's throwing a lot of these big old interest ball things around. That's okay. But I wonder where the store is supposed to be. Let's do it here. It's a percent D, percent D, P dot X, P dot Y. Yeah, Live Studios, what's up, man? Yeah, sorry, I'm just about to shut it down today. I've already been streaming for almost 3 hours, so. No, the pigeons have been there, yeah, and they're cool. The pigeons will actually migrate across the overworld map. So when you scare them, they actually fly to a nearby area, and they'll be in that nearby area waiting for you. And then if you go to the nearby area and scare them again, they go to another nearby area. So they migrate. Oh, I was trying to look at this and see here's secret at. But where is the store at? No, there's no store. Oh, it might be one. Oh, yeah, it has to be one. Okay. That's cool. Oh, you went to the Giant's Causeway? Oh my God, that looks so beautiful. That totally inspired me to do these hexagonal mountains, but I actually ended up on rectangular style mountains instead. So the store is at 1-0 in this world. But I am considering adding both kind of styles of mountains. So there might be another style where yeah, it'll have different shaped mountains basically. Cool. So yeah, we've got this the stairs to there. It's close to the beginning, so that's good enough. that's really the big touch I wanted to add there. So yeah, so that's it for today's stream, you guys. I gotta run because I know my friend's gonna be here any second, and I wanted to get this build ready for him, and I think this is playable enough right now. So I think I'm gonna build it and put it on a jump drive so he can play. So I'll be catching you guys later tomorrow. Same time.